In our previous video, we saw how to profile our application using ClinicJS. So in this series, we are discussing about how to improve performance of our application. So we already saw how to profile our heap memory, which will help us to improve our RAM memory consumption, and it will certainly help you to improve your performance as well. Well, improvement of performance is not something like you can improve one thing and entire application will be optimized. You have to continuously look into other things which are continuously making your application slower. So while looking into other factors of slowness of any application, we must look into the code which we have already written, because there is high chances that there is a scope of improvement. Okay, and even if you have already written optimized code, if you are using any other third party libraries, that might be causing problem. But we need to know and we need to figure out how we can improve it. All right. Improvement will be possible only when you know the problem. Well, how to find out the problem is the biggest problem here. Okay. So now, in order to find, is there any problem in your code or not, you have to simply profile it. So like we discussed in our previous video, we are going to use ClinicJS for profiling our application. And we saw there are three different types of graphs ClinicJS providing us. So let's see all of those one by one. First, we'll go with flame graph. Now, what is flame graph? Let's see, you have written one function which is calling another function, and another function is calling any other function. Okay, so all these type of function, so we can say it is a stack. All right, so the base function, the first function, let's say it is a function f1. So let's look at this diagram. As you can see, this is clearly mentioning the flame graph itself. So here, as you can see, my function f1 is my main function in my main file. So whenever I'll start my server, this function 1 will get called first. Okay, now function 1 is dependent on two different functions, function 2 and function 3. As you can see here, function 2 and function 3 mention just on the top of function 1. Okay, and function 3 is calling another function, let's say function 2 again. So that will be dependent on function 2. Alright, so this is how we write code, and this is how we reuse code. Alright, well, now while writing code, we know what type of code we have written and which function is dependent on which other functions, right? But let's say if we are using any third party library which is using multiple functions, and then how will we get to know that which function is taking more time to execute and how we can optimize it? All right, here we are not talking about there is error in the code or the code will not work. Here we are simply talking about the function which is taking more time. We are going to optimize that function. At least we'll look into that function. If there is a scope of improvement, then only we'll improve it. Otherwise, we'll just keep it as it is. All right. So let's try to generate our first flame graph. So as you can see, this is the code which we have written in our previous videos, where we saw how to use MongoDB and SQL, and we saw how to create APIs. Okay. So now let's try to use one command. So this is the command we saw in our previous video, where it is saying, it is calling a ClinicJS. And the second thing is the type of graph you want. If you want bubble graph, you can put bubble graph here. If you want to create flame graph, you can simply put flame graph here. I already explained what is AutoCannon. It will help ClinicJS to send multiple requests on a server, so that ClinicJS can collect much more information about our code. All right, and the next part is you have to give name of your file. So this is going to be your main file. This is my main file, which is index.js, is my main file. If you have different name of main file, you can simply write that. Okay, so you just have to click on the enter button, and let me just provide password. Now it will start profiling and collecting information. Well, as you can see, these are all multiple requests has been sent by AutoCannon, and at the same time ClinicJS is collecting information. Now it has started analyzing the data and it will create one HTML file for us. Just wait for a while. Okay, so now as a final output we got link to one HTML file. Let's simply copy this and paste it inside the browser. Okay, so this is how flame graph look likes. So let's understand what actually the ClinicJS doing. Well, it has collected all information, all stack information. So stack is nothing but this is the same thing what we are talking about, but this is nothing but the stack. So let's say first function is calling second function or third function. This type of information is being collected by our ClinicJS, and that information finally, while analyzing, it has created one SVG. So if I look into the code of HTML file, let's see. Yeah, this is our HTML file. So as you can see, you will get this type of href. Okay, and this is your SVG. Well, so this is all been taken care by ClinicJS. Just don't need to worry about that. Let's come back on our browser window. Okay, so now this is the type of graph we got here. Well, at this moment we are completely unaware about this, how it is working and what is actually flame graph. So let's understand this one by one. First of all, flame graph name itself suggests that flame is nothing but the way of fire, alright? So fire has multiple colors. It has green color sometimes, it has red color and then yellow color. So red color means function is hot. That means it is the time when CPU was too much engaged and CPU was too much busy, all in all we can say. So if any color is showing, depends on color, as you can see different types of color that they have given. Okay, so all these colors are representing how much CPU busy was at that time. So if I click on this, so as you can see here, CPU was that much busy. You don't need to remember the actual value, just simply you can see the different colors and say that this is at that time CPU was busy. But this is not important data for our improvement. This is not a type of data we are looking for. We are looking for those type of functions which is taking more time. Okay, so let's understand how it works. So this is the two-dimensional graph, and horizontal line is representing the amount of time any particular function has spent on CPU. So let's say this is the logger, and you can see the percentage on right hand side corner right here. So if I hover on this, you will say 13% of time has been spent on CPU by this logger function. So horizontal line is representing amount of time our particular function has spent on CPU, while vertical line is representing the depth of function. We already saw in this diagram, as we move on, any function is calling another function and it is going on and on and on, and that is what we can see here. This file or function is calling out this function and then this, and somewhere it will come to end. So this is the biggest stack, as you can see, we have in our graph. Okay, so what we have understood from this graph, let's understand how it works first. Well, coloring, you don't need to worry about which color is there. Even if it is completely red, you don't need to worry about that, because CPU state or CPU conditions keeps on changing. If I execute this command again, it will give me different type of error. It will give me a different type of graph, because each time CPU state is different, alright? So you don't need to worry about this type of coloring things, okay? Things which we are going to observe is this horizontal line. So bigger is the horizontal block, so that means that particular function or that particular file is taking much more time to execute. Now Let's take one example. Here you can see we have logger, okay? So that logger is taking more time comparatively to other applications, and it is calling too many other functions as well. So what I can do here, I can go here, and inside of this logger, I'll simply stop exporting it. If that package is consuming too much CPU, we can surely find any alternative. So like I saw here in logger.js, we get in Morgan, we get the Morgan function is taking much more time on CPU. So I'll go and simply uninstall that and see what type of output we can get. So let me go here and let me comment this out first. Okay, so now our Morgan is commented. Let me go back here. And let's just clear this and regenerate the flame graph. Okay, so it has started profiling our application again. Okay, so we get another link. Let's just open it in the new tab. Okay, so now we got output. Okay, so now we got another output file here. So let's just copy this link and paste it here. So as you can see here, if I look into this graph, I cannot see this logger. Okay, so that means we have simply improved performance, although that Morgan is not that important, so I can remove it. But if I could have seen like this, I might have missed to optimize that. But with this graph, I can clearly see it is occupying a lot of CPU, so that reason, if it is unnecessary, let's remove that. So with this way, you can see all these functions, and if I double click on any function, it will simply get expanded and you can see more clearly all the entire stack. Okay, so if any function is there which you find that not useful that much, or you have other alternatives, or you can write your own logic, so you can do that as well. Okay, so now we just saw how to use flame graph, and you can simply see the bunch of options here. Let's quickly recap all the options we have here. So the first thing we can see here, there are different colors of lines, and these colors are nothing but representing that CPU busyness. If CPU is too much busy doing other tasks, so that will go in the red section. So amount of the busyness of CPU at that particular time of executing function will get colored in that particular color. Okay, so as you can see here, there is no red color. I'm seeing there is no color red, so that means our CPU was not that busy. Okay, let's say if you want to improve this particular file, you can see at the top, you can see the entire path of that particular file where that function is written, and you can visit that file and see if you can improve that. Here at the right hand side, you can see the stack info, and there is a different percentage. You can look into that. Also, you get some options at below, so you can check and check if you want to just see weird engine statistics, not Node.js, not WebAssembly, not even SRC folder. So you can do that as well. So you can see here, this is all weird engine, which is not occupying that much CPU percentage because there is no big horizontal line here. Okay, if I want to see only my source code, not any other thing, I can do that as well. So this is all my source code. So in my source code, logs, logger.js is only consuming a lot of CPU. So I can certainly improve that as well. Okay. So with this way, you will get access, you will get more deeper information about your code, and later on you can improve it. Well, that's all about the flame graph. See you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.